Hello and welcome to Chapter 9. Today I'm going to combine two lessons, Lesson 6 and Lesson 7, to try to keep us moving along. So today we're going to be adding and subtracting mixed numbers. Let's get started. So I went through the examples in the book and I don't really love how they were teaching it. So I'm going to use the examples from the book, but I'm going to show you kind of some different ways of doing it. So what I'd like you to do is get out a piece of paper or your math notebook and take some notes as I'm going through this. Okay, so let's get started. Madison made a fruit salad. She used 3 1/4 cups of strawberries and 2 1/4 cups of strawberries. Blueberries, sorry. How many cups of berries did she use altogether? Okay, so when we're adding, I like to write the fractions of the mixed numbers on top of each other. So I like to do 3 1/4 plus 2 1/4. Okay, then I'm going to add my my fractions together. 1/4 plus 1/4 equals 2/4. 2/4. And then I'm going to add my whole numbers together. 3 plus 2 is 5. 5 2/4. Now, this is where I saw a lot of kids make mistakes on their pretest, is they forgot to simplify. When I look at the fraction part of this, 2/4, I notice they're both even numbers. So I can divide both the numerator and denominator by 2. To get 2 divided by 2 is 1, 4 divided by 2 is 2, to get 1/2. Now, to rewrite my whole answer, I'm going to rewrite it as 5 1/2. And then I should see what's my unit, cups of berries. So I'm going to write that down. Cups of berries. Okay, so that's all we have to do is line up our fractions, line up our whole numbers, and we can add the fractions, add the whole numbers together to get our total. Let's look another way. All right, so let's look a different way. This way we're going to do improper fractions. So if I have 1 1/3, an easy way to turn that into an improper fraction is to do what I like to call circle up. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to take 3 times 1, and then I'm going to add in the numerator. I'm circling up. So 3 times 1 is 3, plus 1 more is 4. And the denominator stays the same. I'm going to do the same to 2 1/3. 3 times 2 plus 1. Circle up. 3 times 2 is 6. Plus 1 more is 7/3. So that's kind of a quicker way other than drawing out a model and that sort of thing. Just circle up. Okay, so now if I want to add these two improper fractions together, I can do that by taking 4 plus 7 and getting 11/3. And then I need to make that into a mixed number, because really we don't like to write our answers as improper fractions. We like to write them as mixed numbers or simplified fractions. So let's divide that out. Top, 11, divided by the bottom, 3. 11 divided by 3 goes in there 3 times, minus 9. I have 2 left over, okay? So that 2 is my numerator, and the 3 out here is my denominator. 3 2/3 is my final answer. Now, if I think about that, I can count by 3s, 3, 6, 9, and then my next one would be 12. Okay, so I didn't quite get to 11. So then I'd say, okay, so I have 1 2 3 holes, and then I have 10, 11, so I have 2 out of 3 left over. So I have 3 holes, 2/3 left over. Okay? So that is the two, well, let me see, I think I have a couple more examples here. Oh, yes. Okay, so let's find the sum. And write it in simplest form. So if I take 2 3, oh, my pen turned off. 2 and 3 sixths plus 2 and 1 sixth, I would get 4 sixths, and 2 and 2 is 4. Okay, so if I want to simplify, don't forget to simplify, I can divide by 2, divide by 2. Are you always going to divide by 2? No. In this case, they've been giving us even numbers, so we know that they both can be divided by 2. 4 divided by 2 is 2. 6 divided by 2 is 3. So this is the fraction. This is the whole number. If I put it together, I would get 4 and 2 thirds for my answer. So let's talk about this. Here I'm trying to add 10 and 9 twelfths plus 2 and 5 twelfths. Okay, so if I'm going to add these fractions together, I'm going to get 14 twelfths, okay, and 10 plus 2 is 12. Now, I have a problem here because this is improper. So I'm going to split this improper fraction in two, over here, 12 twelfths, because that makes a 1. They do this thing on your book. Pretend like this looks like a 1, because 12 twelfths is actually just 1. Plus 2 twelfths. Okay, so that's going to make up 14 twelfths, right? 12 twelfths plus 2 twelfths makes 14 twelfths. Now this 12 twelfths actually makes a 1. So I'm going to add 1 to my whole number to get 13. And then I have 2 twelfths left over. Now I notice that needs to be simplified. So I'm going to divide by 2, divide by 2. And I am going to get 13 and 1 sixth for my answer here. Like, that's a lot of steps here, guys. So another option here would be to turn it into an improper fraction. So if I did 12 times 10, 120 plus 9, I get 120. I'm going up here because I ran out of room down there. 129 twelfths. Plus 2 times 12 is 24 plus 5 is 29 twelfths. Okay, so if I say, okay, what's 129 plus 29? 158 twelfths. Yeah, I don't know, this one seems a little more complicated. Well, let's give it a shot. So if I take 158 divided by 12, it's going to go in there once, minus 12. 15 minus 12 is 3, bring down the 8. 38 divided by 12 is going to go in there 3 times, minus 36. I'm left with 2. So again, this is my numerator. Denominator, okay, then I need to simplify and get 1/6, 13 and 1/6. So, I mean, this one saves you the step of having to split apart 14 twelfths. So you can kind of pick, do I want to do improper fraction way or do I want to do ungrouping way where I have to kind of split up my improper fraction. So anyways, 13 and 1/6 years old is our answer. Okay, let's go to subtracting. Now with subtracting, we're doing the same thing. These examples are on page 599. You can pause the video and turn to there so you can kind of read the question with me, or just watch the video. Olivia had 4 3/4 box of games. She gave 1 1/4 of the boxes to her brother. How many boxes of games does she have left? Now, this to me is just a silly question. Why is she splitting up her boxes of games? But nonetheless, we're going to do some math here. So if I have 4 3/4 minus 1 1/4, look at this here. 3/4 minus 1/4 is 2/4. 4 minus 1, 3. Then I need to simplify my fraction. to 1/2. So my new answer is 3 1/2 boxes of games. I don't know. Again, how do you split up a box of games? Okay. So there we go. Let's go to the next one. 3 1/5 minus 2 2/5. Okay, now this is going to require some ungrouping, because if I have 1/5, I cannot take away 2/5, right? It's just kind of saying, if I have one apple, can I give two away? No, because I only have one. So we got to watch out for these guys. So what I'm going to do for this one is I'm going to ungroup my 3. So now I have 2. Just like if I was regular subtracting and I had to ungroup, I'd do the same thing. Now I took away 1, so I'm going to add 1 over here. So how I'm going to do that is I'm going to look at my denominator, 5. And I want a common denominator because I'm adding. If I'm adding and subtracting, I need those common denominators. Okay, and so I'm going to add 1, which is just 5/5. Okay, and so I'm going to get 6/5 here now. So let's see, can I do 6/5 minus 2/5? Yeah, I can. 6/5 minus 2/5 equals 4/5. Look at that. Nice. Okay, so I have 4/5 here. And 2 minus 2 is 0. So my answer is 4/5. So this is like ungrouping way, I guess. Let's check to do improper fraction way. 5 times 3. I'm going too fast. Let me turn this into an improper fraction here. 5 times 3 is 15 plus 1 is 16/5. Okay, then I'm going to do 2 2/5. 5 times 2 is 10 plus 2 more is 12/5. Okay, so if I'm subtracting here, 16 minus 12 is 4. My denominator does not change, so I get the same answer of 4/5. And this one I don't have to do any ungrouping. I have to do change mixed number to improper fraction. But notice we get the same answer both ways. So let's do another one here. Okay, so I have 5 4/8 minus 1 1/8. Okay, so I can subtract these. 4 - 1 = 3/8. 5 - 1 = 4. 4 3/8 is my answer. That wasn't so bad. Okay, let's try another one. 6 1/3 minus 2 2/3. Okay, this is an option or example where I cannot just subtract. I need to do some ungrouping. So I have a couple options here. I can make this into improper fractions. How I'm going to do that again is take my denominator, multiply it by the whole number. 3 times 6 is 18, plus 1 more is 19/3. Then I can circle up here too. 3 times 2 is 6, plus 2 more is 8/3. And if I subtract this, 19 minus 8 is 11/3. Okay. So then I have the option of doing top numerator divided by the denominator. 3 goes into 11 3 times, subtracting 9, which leaves me 2 left over. 3 and 2, which is my denominator, thirds. Okay, so let's try this with ungrouping here. So this is using improper fractions. Ooh, it's not going to let me move it. Okay. I'll just come over here then. So I'm going to ungroup the 6, take 1 away, and add it to here. So 1/3 plus 3/3 is going to give me 4/3. I'm going to write it over here. I think I can squeeze it in. 4/3. So if I do 4/3 minus 2/3, 4 minus 2 is 2. 5 minus 2 is 3. So there's both ways, subtracting using mixed numbers and subtracting using improper fractions. I just really want to give you lots of examples so you can pick the one that you like the best. Both are perfectly fine. So my answer is 3 2/3. Let's do a couple more. Okay, so we have a couple options here. Good, looks like these are both. So I'm going to do these both ways, okay? So this one will be improper fraction. So if I do 6 times 10 is 60, plus 2 is 62. 6ths minus 6 times 7 is 42, plus 3 is 45. 6ths. Okay, so if I do 62 minus 45, I'd get 17, and then my denominator stays the same. Now this is improper, so I have to switch it back. So I have 6, 12. Okay, so I have two wholes. And then if I see how many I have to add on, I have to add 5 more out of 6 total. 2 and 5 sixths. Okay, another way that I like to do that is I can do top divided by the bottom. 17 divided by 6. 6 goes into 17 twice, minus 12. I have 5 left over. Remember, this is my numerator. This is my denominator. 2 and 5 sixths. Okay, so let's do this one the other way with ungrouping. So if I have 7 and 3 tenths, minus 5 and 5 tenths. Cannot take 3 minus 5, so I have to ungroup my 7. Get a 6. So if I'm going to add 1, which I'm going to add 10 tenths. Notice I just look at my denominator here and keep the same denominator because we need common denominators if I'm going to add or subtract. I take 3 plus 10 is 13 tenths. Okay, now I can subtract. 13 minus 5 is 8 tenths. Notice how it's 10, 10, 10, 10, 10. We don't change the denominators unless we're multiplying for some reason, but we do not want to change the denominators. 6 minus 5 is 1. Now I'm noticing, okay, this is where I'm going to change the denominator. I'm noticing that 8 tenths, I can reduce it. So I'm going to divide by 2 since they're both even numbers. 8 divided by 2 is 4. 10 divided by 2 is 5. Okay, so I have 1 whole, don't forget your whole, and 4 fifths left over. Okay, this is a long one today. I apologize for that. But please do your best to get your work done. And I will see you tomorrow. Make sure you ask me if you have any questions. Bye.